I'm single, which is sad because I'm also bi.
Okay. That's like having an empty plate at a buffet. That's what.
Yeah. I'm bi, the world is my buffet. One second.
Correct.
Okay. It's just heart is open. No, heart is closed, legs are open. That's the kind of... Thank you for the three girls.
Are you guys also bi? Is that...
Are you,
okay, all three of you?
I'm sorry, okay, you stop okay. talking.
Hi. Zomato. What?
What's up? My name is Ayushi. It's nice to meet you.
Oh, y'all just walk like this. What? Bye, kaun hai yahan pe?
Actually, wait. I, okay.
So, sab log bye hai, but sab log hi bol rahe.
No, it's just, I'm trying to find someone, mm-hmm. but I want passenger princess treatment.
See, I'm old person. Mm. What is passenger princess treatment?
Okay.
Is this a feature in Uber that I was not aware of?
No, it was how Diana died.
Oh my god. Now, here are the perks of being a passenger princess.
Okay.
You never have to drive.
Okay.
Anywhere, ever.
Yeah, I know this. My wife is a passenger princess.
Yes!
I got it. Okay, so passenger princess is literally a passenger who's a princess.
No, it's not like
so you do, you don't
know, it's a sexual thing.
Not.
Yeah, even I thought it's some interest.
I thought it's like when you watch your partner have sex. That's hey, I'm passenger princess.
Yes. But yeah, you're also wearing a tiara, so yeah. It's...
What if the person doesn't have a car? We'll take a rickshaw. Both of us are passenger princesses right now.
Backseat princesses.
Are you open to being a pillion princess?
No, but I said, I'm still confused. So as an Oxford Dictionary... definition of passenger princess would be what?
A girl who is tired of being a strong, independent woman.
Who is tired?
You basically want someone to be nice to you.
Yes.
Right. Okay.
So oh my god! And like a text back would be so nice. Oh. Meera din ban jayega full.
God. Man, you have such low standards.
Yeah. what kind of princess is this?
Ayushi, you need to hook up with Urban Clap right now. Because they are being nice and texting like anything. You have no idea. Dude, SMS pay SMS, not stopping.
So if this is the passenger princess, then who is this? Is this...
Driver King.
You.
I think... Yeah.
This is the wrong Netflix documentary.
Driver King.
Lamba bhaada chahiye humko.
As someone who's bisexual, you must be facing a lot of like misconceptions by straight folks like me, right? Mm. So what are your usual, what are your top three? Hey, this is not how it is. 1, 2, 3.
So far, it's been three straight men talking about gay culture. It's all wrong.
Yeah. Okay. So you tell us.
Okay. How many have y'all seen scissoring videos ever on porn? Like when you watch porn.
Rob on Music, Art and Dance taught me scissoring.
What?
Yeah.
Guilty. When I was Pogo?
Yeah.
Huh? What? I'm sorry, what? Oh my god, just. Scissoring is not a thing. It's not a real thing when women sleep with each other. There are the two bi girls who are just nodding profusely.
So scissoring is. The women don't do this? This is scissoring, right?
It's a performative thing that you make for straight men to watch porn.
Yeah, I'm gonna comment next time. Fake!
Scissoring is not a thing. You often get, bi people mostly get like, which is better? You know, you like guys more or girls more? And I'm like, do you like biryani more or pizza? Like, it's two amazing things individually.
Pizza.
Wow.
Yeah, I like pizza more, yeah. It's a very...
It's very low effort.
So you're saying that like sometimes you feel like, no, I'm not feeling like a pizza today. I feel like let's cut out the gluten.
I don't think any like bi person goes out and they're like, oh, I feel like a boy today, or I feel like having a girl today. It's
yeah,
not like
that's
that.
What, yeah, yeah.
It's more, it's person versus correct. Sexuality.
Got
now
it.
You're straight, right? How many right. straight people here? Give me a cheer.
Disgusting.
All of them.
Cancel them.
I mean, cool, enjoy. Fine. All straight people are not attracted to all straight, like if all straight men are not attracted to all straight girls, correct. Right? So would, I mean, just because you're straight, you wouldn't look and be like, haan, sab chalega.
Exactly. There have been times. Many moons ago.
Yeah.
In question is like, ek se shaadi kar li. Say for example, you're a bi girl and you marry a straight man.
Correct.
Toh tu ke shaadi ke baad straight bin gayi. And you're like, no.
But that's not it, yeah.
Right? You're still just choosing pizza.
You're like, gender. Exactly. I've chosen this guy, but I'll cheat on him.
But yeah.
I don't mind.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
All queer people cheat. That's not true. That's not true at all.
Hey, clip oh my God. This and put out.
Just without context. Straight.
The episode is going to start with all queer people cheat.
A lot of queer people don't need to cheat because they're all poly.
Okay.
You know? Do you know what poly is?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah,
my cousin's daughter, right? How did you know polygamy?
I fucked up.
Very nice, very nice.
I, you know, y'all are because y'all are reacting to. I have slept with more women than all of them put together. Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, look at this lineup. There's nothing to boast about. To be very honest.
Which is why it's easy. Moving on.
Wait, if you're on Bumble and you yeah. match with another woman,
yes.
who texts first or both? Either of you can. Because that's a woman.
Great question.
It's a good question.
This is 10 marks answer.
Yeah. Is it a pehle aap situation? That's
it's pehle app.
Whoever swiped right first has to message.
Oh, that's good because I thought them gay guys just can't text each other. Only, right? Hey, sorry, dude.
I did this once. I was arguing with a guy. Basically, I was trying to park in one place and this woman was not moving. Okay, so I
as a human or as a car?
Woman as a human. Yeah.
Ah, okay. So
woman
just
was just standing. It was like outside like Bade Mia. Like you go outside Bade Mia, you eat like in the car only. So I'm parking and this woman is not moving. So I was honking at her. Okay. And she was like, oh, this is my spot. And I was like, let me just park and you can come back. Okay. Then her husband came or her boyfriend. He was like, where can they go blow the cab? She wants to stand there. She can stand. Okay. So I was just like, hey, is this good? Y'all can fight with me right now. This is going to be a problem forever. Where you are just going to fucking make a big deal out of her being irrational. And they stopped fighting with me because they realized a fundamental problem in their relationship.
Whoa.
Whoa, when are they coming on relationship, by the way?
I love how Ronak's car is a mobile relationship therapy van.
Yeah.
Roaming the streets of Mumbai, just correcting everyone. She doesn't respect you because she hated her father.
Do you feel like when you validate each other, it's a good thing in a relationship, but also like not a great thing? I'll explain to you. Okay, like my parents are like old school, dysfunctional arranged marriage. Like my dad has road rage like I do.
Okay.
But my mom is very much like if my dad is fighting with someone, my dad's like, chhod do, he's crazy. And like my dad gets to be like, main maarunga tere ko, par meri biwi mere ko rok rahi hai. But like I feel like my wife, when I get into road rage, my wife also gets in.
Oh.
So I'm like, hey, mother, she's like, mother,
yeah.
So
yeah.
And that's the worst.
So yeah,
this is relationship goals right
yeah.
there.
Yeah, which is great. It sounds good on theory because you want someone to validate you, you know. But I feel like if you were a little old school and stopped me, that guy wouldn't come out of his car to hit me. You know, because he's not going to do anything to my wife, right? He's going to be like, kya tum log a problem hai? Yeah. And now I am like, chhod do unhe.
Hi, it's your boy Michelle Obama. I have some quick announcements to make. I am going on tour all of this month. I'm performing in these cities. Come watch me live. The ticket link for my show Manchild is in the pinned comment and in the description. You can find these tickets and book my show. Now, more important, I'm performing on the 5th of May in Mumbai at the Sophia's Bhabha Auditorium. I would love for you to come. It's the same show, Manchild. I'm taping it for YouTube as a special. It would mean the world if you came. Buy tickets. Come, fill it up. This is the first time I'm going to be doing my solo show in an auditorium this big. I am very excited. And in the excitement, I might call your mother up and I might meet her, take her out for dinner and drinks. And later on at night, we might have sex. This weekend, I'm doing my tour in Bangalore and Hyderabad. Come watch. Before we move on, I want to give a quick shout out to the sponsors of this episode, HempLifeCo.in. They make safe and legal medicinal cannabis products. That's right, I said safe, I said legal. It is made in India by the people, for the people, and it will be delivered to your doorstep. They have just launched Indi 39,000 MG, which is a full spectrum product which will help you with pain, insomnia, stress, anxiety, inflammation, sleep, you name it. They sell products on prescription, over-the-counter, as well as PET CBD oils. Hemp Life Co, ladies and gents, check out their link in the description. Let's get back to the show!
How you been, Chak? Where are you?
Good. Still in a relationship. Same one.
Same one?
Yeah, it's been now 4.5 years.
Woo!
And,
woo!
Yes. We were in a long-distance relationship for 2.5 years or whatever. So now we live close to each other and we were like, hey, let's move in together. Till we started spending more time with each other. Okay. And we're like, let's live separately only for now. Because we live very differently from each other. Like, her place of putting shoes is very different from where I would put my own shoes.
Where would you put your shoes?
Like, I would put my shoes right next to the door so that, you know, shoes don't come into the house.
And she would put it on your chest.
Yeah.
Just tie it around her neck and roam around with it.
I have asked so many times. For and then she likes to put clothes in a specific space.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like,
no, like a house. Functioning adult.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm like, I've gotten this house as a space to put things.
Right.
Correct. As a whole, like the world is your cupboard.
The world is my cupboard. Yeah. So those problems. It's like,
wow.
The more time, when we don't spend time with each other at all, we're like, hey, we should live together. And then as soon as it crosses 3 hours of us spending time together,
you call the broker again.
Yeah.
No, I'm just, so the simple solution is just have like extra bedroom. Life is sorted.
Sorry if I don't make your kind of money also.
Hey, listen, you can go and live in Thane peacefully, okay? Nobody's stopping you from having a relationship and living in Thane.
Yeah. You know, the fabric softeners we use to wash our clothes is also different.
Really? Is that why you're not fucking living
No,
together?
It's just...
Because she uses Ujala and you don't?
Yeah.
I'm also very low-key impressed you knew what that was before you started dating her.
No, I didn't know what it was before. And that also happened, like, she has a proper job and stuff and I do this.
Correct.
So...
That you gets know, in the way.
Yeah, so she's like, you'll be at home all day using up the AC and everything. So why should I pay half?
Yeah.
And I'm like,
no, that's true. But also, since you're home all day, you could pick up the shoe and put it in the rack also, na?
Also, since
I could have become an engineer also. There are a lot of
no, now that ship done. Has sailed.
But since you're home all day, you can order her fabric softener and empty it and put yours inside it.
Oh, dude. Yeah. That's a,
and just completely that. Gaslight her sense of smell. What? This is not this is not lavender. Smells like rose to me.
Okay. You gaslighting. I'll try that.
I'm 34M. I'm dating a girl my age since 2 years. It's very mature / peaceful because we both have grown from past bad relationships. We were drinking by ourselves and it became one of those nights. I told her it's a no judgment zone that we should share embarrassing stories.
Oh, one of those nights.
And a classic mistake.
Stupid man.
From our past.
Nice.
I said I used to steal cash from my dad's wallet at 15.
Ha.
Disgusting.
Respectable. <That's... laughs> When it was her turn, she said that when she was 19, she had sex with a guy, and when her period was late, he ghosted her.
Whoa. Dude, now stealing money feels so little compared to what she... He has to redo his story. I'm actually 18 tak churata tha. Theek hai, sorry.
Aur mere periods bhi nahi aate the.
So she had sex with a boy who had a crush on her, because if she was pregnant, her crush would think that the baby is his.
Oh, dude. She changes fabric softeners in her boy.
Then she laughed it off, saying luckily she wasn't pregnant. I know, I said it's a non-judgment zone. I love straight boys so much, dude. I know I said it's a non-judgment zone, but I can't stop thinking about it, what to do.
Oh. Dude, you must have felt like, fuck, yeah, this relationship has gone for a toss, but my story sucks.
Now he'll use this story in his next relationship.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay, once I missed my period and...
We don't know what he stole it for. He must have stolen it for an abortion.
This honesty ruins relationships.
I think he was trying to...
No, like, there is honesty and then there is too much honesty.
Yeah.
Like, present honesty is good. Past honesty, very bad.
Present honesty...
Like,
for example,
honesty about the present and your present relationship, be honest about everything in it.
Correct.
Past, why you want to be honest?
Past, you have to be dishonest.
Yeah, not dishonest. Just be like, ki mera past hai nahi.
Yeah.
I was born last year.
Yeah. I showed up like Mr. Bean.
Yeah.
Is that what you told your wife?
She was past, present, future, everything. First girlfriend I married. Oh. Yeah, you say that now.
Disgusting.
Also, I would not invite this couple to my house. Because I'd be like, yaar, koi wallet se paise chura raha hai, koi bachcha chhod ke ja raha hai. You never know what's gonna happen at this house party.
Is that a common con? That, hey, I missed my period, so let me latka out this kid on someone else.
Once I hooked up with a couple of people in the same week. My period was late. I called my best friend and I was like, oh, fuck, I'm late. I don't know what to do. I'm not. So she says, can you call the guy and let him know? And so I said, which one?
Oh.
Exactly. And so then she said, pick a third. Who is responsible?
Oh, wow.
And that's what I did.
Oh, I thought you would do like a group call. Ke, hello, sabko awaaz aa rahi hai.
तुम लोग पापा बनने वाले हो?
Is the plot of Mamma Mia?
It's the plot of Mamma Mia.
What happens in that? The Meryl Streep.
It's not a non-judgment zone, but also plagiarism zone. Clearly.
What happens?
With like three different guys at the same time.
Right.
Has a daughter. At the daughter's wedding, she wants to get her dad, and then she calls these three guys.
Oh, but that's very different.
Does Meryl Streep know who the father is, or she's also like, I'll figure it out?
So she's left with three guys, like pretty much around the same.
Yeah,
correct.
Right. So she doesn't know, right? So she's not conning them.
Yeah. Yeah.
She's like playing Kulja Simsim. Yeah. Right? There's three doors. Which one is mine?
Yeah, but that'd be fun. Like the woman would do like a father reveal party. Like,
gender and father both.
It's three guys waiting their turn.
It's like she bursts the balloon. Ramesh ke cheese ke.
I think you should keep getting a drunk every week to keep.
Yeah, this is so no judgment zone.
To find out what other cons she was doing when she was 19.
Yeah. He should start raising the stakes of his con every week.
Correct.
Yeah.
You know,
ek bar main bank rob kiya tha. Your turn.
Every weekend she gives like a better story. She's like, "Take all Vijay Malaga story."
Thing I actually respect her. She's like a go-getter, dude. Ki father, to main lekar aungi apne bache ke liye koi bhi ho.
Yeah, hustle mentality. She went.
It's your biceps, the mother.
she went and got a replaceable father. Placeholder. When it did not work out, she was like, "Abhi tu bhi hat yaar se." And then this was when she was 19. A lot of growth happened. She probably no longer cons people. Right?
Yeah.
Right?
I think this is the con she got ghosted at. He can, no problem.
Bro, what about the crush?
What about the crush?
What about her? 1 second, guys.
One second. So you think that because she got ghosted, that crush has to be a father?
Yeah. So this is like saying ki koi mera baap murder kiya, to main mera crush ka baap murder kar diya. As revenge. How does this make any sense?
Oh, that's like saying koi mera baap murder kiya, abhi tera baap mera baap.
I'm 24 female. My boyfriend of 10 years kept insisting that I meet his mom. I kept avoiding because I was very embarrassed. When we were in school, once she messaged me from my boyfriend's phone saying, "Stop calling and texting Darshil at these odd hours. He's trying to study." Classic.
Darshil.
Safari.
Kya itna bura hoon main saasu maa? I didn't want Darshil to be mad at his mom, so I never told him. Yesterday, he said to me that he's very serious about us and we'll only be able to take the next step if our families are familiar with each other.
Usually how it works, yeah.
Yeah.
So I brought up the courage to meet Auntie. My plan was to address the elephant in the room and bring it up at the start only. Auntie laughed it off, saying that this was Darshil's old trick. Aur wo mummy ke kandhe pe banduk chalata tha. I got furious with Darshil in private after meeting, and he said that his mom is lying because she doesn't want them to have a bad start to their relationship. Who do I believe?
Guys, the solution is simple. They need to get drunk, have a no judgment zone.
Yeah, you know what? It really depends on how well Darshil did in his studies. You know, if he really did great in his studies, then he can be like, "Look, I had to lie to, you know, walk this path of SSE boards."
Thing is, the mother never said don't call him. She just said don't call at these odd hours.
Which
is fine, yaar. Sona hai usko.
Or the insinuation is that he's trying to get her to not call him because he's doing something on the side. Like, please, Darshil is trying to fuck. Please, yeah. You know, like.
He's taking his mom's phone and messaging the dad.
What?
Mama is hungry, so get asking for Darshil.
Yeah, this is just what he does all the time. Like, if mother-in-law is still after their marriage sending these messages.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Then it is worrying.
You know? Darshil is saying, stop making noise in the bedroom.
Well, Darshil is bitter inside.
When I was 14, 15, there was a girl I knew and we sort of liked each other and we would talk often, text each other. Okay. And then she was telling me that after school gets over, my father is forcing me to go to like this fancy, like a IB board or something. My father has this career ambition for me, but I just want to take it easy and not do that for my 11th grade. She's just telling me all this and she's like a little sad and she's crying. And because we were kids, she was like, okay, I need to hang up, and left her phone in her parents' room and went to sleep. And then I just sent her a long text saying, hey, who gives a fuck? You don't need to go to IB. You do what you want, girl. No. It's your life. It's okay. Yeah. And then her dad read it.
Yeah.
And her dad said, don't message Darshil at odd hours.
Yeah. And you should have just said, "Arey, wo mummy kabhi kabhi kande se." You know.
Thinking that maybe it was her only who replied back.
It's possible, but why the fuck would she waste my time crying for 1 hour?
Listen, people have wasted times having fake children with people, all right? This is very small. But to answer the question, who should she believe?
Believe the mother and get more information out about Darshil.
Oh man, this guy watches CID.
Yeah.
I think it should have brought it up at that time only with him and been like, bruh.
Yeah.
WTF.
Like, yeah, that's the thing. She never wanted to bring it up that time because he would be sour with his mom and his mom would send him to boarding school. Because that's what Darshil's mom does.
The thing this relationship needs is Aamir Khan.
Correct. Yeah. Like
coming and saying, "Arey, Darshil draw bahut achha karta." No, 10-year relationship, if this is the only thing that's bothering you, that's good only, yeah.
Yeah, it's true. If it's one good SMS, which in 2008 cost 50 paise, you know, I think.
Night calling was free at
night. Night calling was free.
Ah.
Yeah. Yeah, so she's gonna call her.
That's why she
so that's what the mom was like, you fucking pay to talk to my son, okay? Free shit won't work.
Mera beta shaadi karega to sirf ameer ladki se shaadi karega.
I am 32 male dentist, says man. My girlfriend is a therapist. I met her for 2 sessions and then confessed my love to her.
Oh, lovely.
Classic.
He's trying to save up on therapy money.
That's one way to do it. She was open to dating on the condition that she and I will stop doing therapy and I will visit another therapist. I respected that and we've been together for 3 years.
Oh.
Yeah. Recently, remember, he's dentist. Recently, she's been having some tooth issues. And is requesting that I look into it. I told her that if I have to go to different therapist, she can go to different dentist. She said it's not the same. How should I bring her to respect my profession?
Also, I want to know, like, when he confessed his love and she said, okay, yeah, we can date. Did she take money for that section?
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, yeah, we're done and I love you too, 2,000 rupees.
Yeah, he's got to have like a discounted rate for that session. He's going to be like, come on, yeah, 1,000 ka to chocolates.
Yeah. Come. Yeah, I'm judging therapist only.
Correct.
Little bit.
Yeah. Like, bro, that's
because,
not
because like mentally deranged people are coming to you and you're falling in love with them.
Yeah.
After 2 meetings. Very good.
Some of us are kinky.
Okay. Cannot relate.
I feel like he must be a shitty dentist because if I was married to a dentist, I would not have a cavity in the first place.
I mean, that's not how it works.
No?
Dude, my wife was a dentist. She has done my root canal for me and then she quit dentistry. I swear to you, I'm not even kidding.
Like, never again.
I've been married to dentists for many, I've had many cavities.
You say that he would have to look into his wife's mouth. That would be unattractive.
Listen, he does that already when she's on his knees. She's on her knees.
Oh, wow. I don't think I've really examined
the teeth of people. Man. No, but the point is that I don't think we are examining the mouth of the blowjobber. And being like,
no one is like, even I'm getting on my knees.
You're looking at blow the dandruff jobber. And stuff, dude. What are you doing?
Blowjobber is the best.
Yeah, blowjobber and blowjobby. I mean, it's
not the girl, it's the blowjobber.
Yeah. There's a therapist and therapy.
Therapist and therapy, yeah.
Yeah.
And then when you're angry, the therapist. Sorry.
I think he should tell her, okay, fine. Open up her mouth. Lock it with whatever they lock it. And then be like, oh, jab main bachcha tha, meri mummy bahut. And she's just stuck there.
This is a non-judgment zone. But this is an ego issue for him, no? Because the end of the question is, how should I bring her to respect my profession? Like, this
respect
is a
my profession.
Respect my profession. Yeah.
Fix her teeth.
Supreme Court also, they have like a one area where there is just it's a non-judgment zone.
Non-judgment zone in the Supreme Court.
In the Supreme Court.
That'd be fun.
Just say whatever the fuck you want. Yeah. Okay,
the judge comes out, bahut paka rahe them all. And those two are engaged, but they only
are confused.
No, they just have like a very base level. Oh, I love coffee. You love coffee. We are two sitcom characters. Let's get married. Yeah, that's pretty.
I mean, listen, people over the ages have got married for less.
For less?
Yeah, it's called arranged marriage.
Yeah.
At least here the arrangement is coffee. So.
Yeah, if like you didn't meet each other and Simati came to you and said, "What you want from girl?" Would you have said, she's got to have a small nose and loves coffee? Is that?
It's like, beta, coffee you will not get. Compromise little tea she will have, beta.
It just It just cuts to Seema. Yeah. Too much coffee you want.